So our base cover goes around the wooden base of the lamp. As we mentioned before, we're going to take a look at this as if it was a weldment. So we're welding four pieces together, and we're going to make a single die that's going to help us hold those pieces together. We're going to start off by making another sketch plane on this bottom face, and we're going to project our sketches back to that plane. And we can select the face on the bottom and have it project all of those elements back. We now need to extrude the main body of our template, and we're going to hide our base cover, and we're going to just extrude this surface up greater than our base cover. So I'm going to select a nice round number again. I'm going to select 70, and I'm also going to extrude this outer edge downwards so that we get some extra material to help support the bottom edge of our components when we assemble them. 3 millimeters. And that should be good enough for us. So let's turn the base cover back on. See how we did? That looks pretty good right there. So this base cover is made of four components that need to get clamped together and welded along these seam lines. And so we're going to make some space for those clamps, and we're also going to make some reliefs in our template, so that way when we do some welding here, it's not going to damage the template overall. We're going to select this bottom surface, and we're going to start a new sketch there. And I'm just going to make a circle that starts on this corner point here, which is where we would be welding. So I'm going to set this to be a 25 millimeter circle. I'm also going to add a circle to these three other tangent points. And I'm not too worried at this point about what those dimensions are, because I'm going to select all of these by shift clicking all of them, and I'm just going to make them all equal. So our one dimension controls these four circles now. And what I'm going to do next is I'm going to extrude these areas out so that they cut through our component. And you can see that they cut through our body here, so I can come into the extrusion feature that's in our history, and I can change the bodies that we're going to be affecting, and I can select the base cover. I hit check, and everything updates correctly, so our base cover is not affected.